I am Bindusri, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering at Institute of Aeronautical Engineering and Technology. Today, we'll discuss about the combinational circuits as well as the sequential circuit. Now, we are going to discuss about the sequential circuit. So, before that, we are discussing about the difference between the combinational circuits and the sequential circuit. So, what is the combinational circuit? So, the combination circuit is depending upon the present inputs only. It's not depending upon the previous inputs. Okay, if you are taking the any output, that output is depending on the present inputs only. So, that is the combinational circuit. It does not depend on the previous inputs. So, now the combination circuit. So, inputs are the X, output is the Z equal to f of x. So, this is the function of x. So, z is the output, f is the function of in x. So, the combination circuit is depending on the present inputs only. So, the output is depending on the present inputs. So, the speed is the very fast. The design is also the very easy. So, the combination circuit is depending on the present inputs only. Combination circuit is designed on the present inputs only. So, how can we design the combination circuits? By using the logic gates, we can design the combination circuit. So, it does not depending on the previous inputs. That means it does not require the any memory. So, no need to take the memory. Memory is not required. So, no feedback loop from the input to the output. So, it is only in the time dependent. So, for construction of the combination circuit, here we are using the logic gates. So, used for arithmetic as well as the Boolean operations. So, by using the, we can construct using the logic gates. So, used for the arithmetics as well as the Boolean operations. So, combination circuit don't have capability to store any state. Why? Because, so here it is not depending on the any inputs. Any means it does not depending on the previous inputs. So, no need to store the any value in this combination circuit. So, that's what here we are not using the any clock. So, don't require the triggering pulses. These circuits do not have any memory element. So, no need to take the memory. It is easy to use and handle. So, what are the example of this one? So, encoder, decoder, multiplexer, demultiplexer, whatever it is, we are taken in this one. So, these circuits are, all others are combination circuit. These combination circuits are depending on the present inputs only. It does not depending on the any outputs. Means, it does not depending on the any previous outputs. For constructing the combination circuit using the logic gates only, we are constructing the combination circuit. Okay, here we are not to use the any memory and the clock. So, next one is the sequential circuit. So, in the sequential circuit, it depends on the present as well as the past inputs. We want to generate the any output. The generating the output is, that output is depending on the present inputs as well as the past inputs also. So, in the combination circuit, we are not using the any clock pulses or triggering pulses. Coming to the sequential circuit, here we are using the some clock pulses. So, here we are taking this one. So, this is the first one is the external input, the combination circuit. So, this is the external output. So, the output is connected to the memory. So, that means, so this is the feedback loop from the output to the input state. Feedback loop from the output to the input state. So, this is the memory element. Next one is the next state, current state, internal output and the internal inputs. So, this output is connected to the, this is the internal input. This means the feedback loop from the sequential circuit. So, this is the internal inputs. So, this is the internal output. So, this is the loop for the feedback loop. Why we are using this memory? So, it is depending on the present and the past inputs. So, that past inputs are stored in this memory. Whenever we are applying the some clock pulses, so it is take the value from the memory. Then, And the, we are giving the some input. So depending on the memory element in this, whatever the value is stored in this memory. So depending on this value and the external input. So based on these two inputs, we are getting the output. This is the sequential circuit. So in this output is depends upon the present as well as the past input. So speed is slow. Why? Because so compared to the combination circuit, that combination circuit is not no need to wait for the any other inputs. So directly whatever the input we are given, so based on that we get the output in the combination circuit. So the speed is the fast. Coming to the sequential circuit, here we are having the one feedback loop is there, some memory is there. So whatever the, if you are producing the some output, so that output is depending on the memory element, whatever the value is stored in that memory and the present input also. Okay, so that's what the speed is the very slow. So here we are having the some feedback path between the input and output. This is the time dependent. Element building blocks are the flip-flops. In the combination circuit, we are using the logic gates, we can construct the combination circuit. So coming to the sequential circuit, using the flip-flops, we can construct the sequential circuit. So mainly used for the storing data. Sequential circuits are have capability to store any state or return to the earlier state. This is the clock dependent, they need to be triggering. It has the some memory element, so it is not easy to use and handle. So the examples are the flip-flops and counters. So the combination circuits and the sequential circuit difference is the, in the combination circuit output is depending on the present input only. It does not use the any clock pulses or triggering pulses. Coming to the sequential circuit, so the sequential circuit output is depending on the present input as well as the past input also. It does not, here we are using the some clock pulses or the triggering pulse. So based using the logic gates, you can construct the combination circuit. Using the flip-flops, we are constructing the sequential circuit. So in the combination circuit, no, we are not having any memory element. Coming to the sequential circuit, here we are having the some memory element. Okay, no feedback loop in the combination circuit. Coming to the sequential circuit, feedback loop is required. It is not easy to handle for this circuit in the sequential circuit. We can easy to construct and easy to use and handle in the combination circuit. So the examples are the flip-flops and the counters in the sequential circuit. Next one is the latch, SR latch. So SR means set and reset. So before going to the SR latch, so what is the latch and what is the flip-flop? So latch and flip-flop both are 1-bit storage element. So the output, we can store the only the 1-bit. We can store the only 1-bit. So this is the only 1-bit storage element. So for the latch, we are not using the any clock pulses. So coming to the flip-flop, we can use the clock pulses. So that is the main difference between the latch and flip-flop. Latch and flip-flop both are 1-bit storage element. Coming to the latch, here we are not using the any clock pulses. Coming to the flip-flop, so you can use the clock pulses. Okay, so now we are going to discuss about the SR latch. So SR, so what is the SR? Set reset in asynchronous device. So what is the asynchronous device? So in this asynchronous is a one type of counter also. So in the asynchronous, so the first clock pulse output is, so in the sequential circuit we are giving the some clock pulse. So initially we are giving the some clock pulse to the one circuit. Again we are using the one more circuit. The first flip-flop output is connected to the second flip-flop clock pulse. So Next one. Next, we are taking the one more clock pulse, one more flip-flop. The second flip-flop output is connected to the third flip-flop clock pulse. So, that is the asynchronous. Coming to the synchronous, we are taking the number of flip-flops. We can take the number of flip-flops. So, only single clock pulse is required. So, by using the single clock pulse, we can design the all the circuit outputs. So here we are taking the n number of flip flops only using the single clock pulse. We can design that one, so we can get the output for the synchronous device. So coming to the asynchronous device, only using the single clock pulse. So first flip flop only we are connecting the single clock pulse. So after that, the first flip flop output is connected to the second flip flop clock pulse input. So this is the asynchronous device. Okay. So by using this one, we can control the signals. We can control the signals and relays on the state of S and R inputs. It stores the only one bit of information. It has the two inputs and the two outputs which are complement to each other. So that means, so here set and reset, S and R are the inputs. So complement of each other. So if for example we are taking the output is the Q. Q is the output. Another output is the Q bar. So here we are using the two inputs and the two outputs. One more is the clock pulse for the synchronous. But in the latch, we are not using the any clock pulse. That's why here we are not constructing the any clock pulse. Okay. So by using the NOR and NAND gates, we can construct the any flip flop. So why we are using the NOR and NAND gates only constructing this one? So NOR and NAND gates are the universal gate. By using the NOR and NAND gates, we can construct the any logic gate. Okay, so that is the reason for using the NOR and NAND logic for constructing the flip-flops. So coming to this one, so this is the logic symbol for the NOR gate. This is the last symbol for the NOR gate. So initially we are having the set and reset inputs, Q and Q bar are the outputs. So coming to this one, so coming to this circuit, so here we are connecting the bidirectional in nature. So what is the bidirectional? So the first one output is connected to the second input. So similarly, the first gate output input is connected to the second gate output. So this is the bidirectional connection in the sequential circuits. Okay. So first one is the R and S input, Q and Q bar are the outputs. So first, before going to this construction, so what is the NOR gate? What is the NOR gate? So this is the NOR gate symbol. A and B are the inputs. A and B are the inputs. So what is the equation for this one? A plus B bar. A plus B bar. So now A and B are the inputs. A plus B bar is the output. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. Okay. Now A plus B bar. So 0 plus 0 is the 0. 0 bar is 1. Next one. 0 plus 1 is 1. 1 bar is 0. 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 bar is 0. 1 plus 1 is 1. 1 bar is 0. So here we are observing both the inputs are 0, then only the output is the 1 in the NAND gates. Any one of the input is 1, any one of the input is 1, automatically the output is the 0. Automatically the output is the 0. When any one of the input is, any one of the input is 1, then the output is the 0. Okay. So similarly, here also we are taking the two inputs and the two outputs. So if you are taking the two inputs, how many combinations are there? So if n equal to 2, so how many combinations are there? N equal to 2 power 2 equal to 4 combinations are there. So that means R and S, Q and Q bar. Okay. So initially 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So, 2 inputs and the 4 combinations, R and S are the inputs, Q and Q bar are the outputs, 0, 0, 0 and 1, 0. So, in the first condition, R equal to 0, S equal to 0. In the first condition, R equal to 0, S equal to 0. This is the first one. So, when R equal to 0, S equal to 0. So, observing this NOR gate truth table, when any one of the input is 1, output is the 0. So here, both the inputs are the 0, 0. Both the inputs are the R equal to 0 and S equal to 0. So, what is the output? So, here, when both the inputs are the 0, so when both the inputs are the 0, the output is the 1. So, here we are not having the any one value is there. Automatically, the value is 1. When both the inputs are 0, 0, the output is the 1. So, similarly also same case. So, for example, Q equal to 1, Q bar equal to 0. If you are taking the Q equal to 1, Q bar equal to 0. So, what happened? So, what is, well, let us assume Q equal to 1, Q bar equal to 0. Why? Because, so here it is depending on the previous state. We don't know the previous state. If Q equal to 1, Q bar equal to 0. So, what happened? So, this 1 is connected to the second gate input. So, here 0 is connected to the second gate. First gate output, first gate input. So now, so when both the inputs are 0, 0, output is the 1. So here this one is connected to here, 0, 1, this output is connected to, so any one of the input is 1, the output is the 1. Zero. Previously also we are having the 1 and 1 0. So, for example, so if you are taking this output is the 0, so this output is the 1. Okay, same case when S equal to 0, R equal to 0. So, when S equal to 0, so we are not assuming that value is the 1 or 0. Okay, so for this purpose, so let us assume the previous outputs are the Q equal to 0 and Q bar equal to 1. So, this 0 is connected to here, this 1 is connected to here. When any one of the input is the 1, the automatically the output is the 0. So, here also 2 zeros are there, the output is the 1. So, what we are observing, so whatever the present states, whatever the previous outputs are present in the Q value, so, if you are applying that values into this one, so we are applying that values in this one, so we are getting the same values. So, that's what when S equal to 0, R equal to 0, when S equal to 0, R equal to 0, what happened? So, no change of the state, no change. So, that means, so previous whatever the values we are having, so that values are given to this NOR gate, so automatically we are getting the previous states only. So, that means no change of the states. When S equal to 0, R equal to 0, no change of the states. So, coming to this one, S equal to 0, R equal to 1. S equal to 0, R equal to 1. So, what we are observing this NOR gate, any one of the input is 1, the output is the 0. Any one of the input is 1, the output is the 0. Okay. So, this 0 is connected to here. When both the inputs are 0, 0, what is the output? When both the inputs are the 0, 0, what is the output? 1 only. Okay, now that 1 is connected to here. So, 1, 1, the output is the 0. The output is a 0. So, here we are having the one of the input is the 1. One of the input is the 1. So, automatically we are easily getting the output. So, next case, when the S equal to 1, R equal to 0. So, that is the this case. So, when the S equal to 1, R equal to 0. So, coming to this one, when the S equal to 0, R equal to 1. So, that means when the S equal to 0, R equal to 1. So, here we are observing, so the name it's called as a SR latch. So, coming to this one, so the first input, first gate input is the R, second gate input is the S. So, that's what when S equal to 1, R equal to 0. So, when S equal to 1, R equal to 0. Okay. So, any one of the input is the one, what is the output? 0. So, 0 and 0, the output is the 1. Okay, so here one of the input is 1, automatically the output is the 0. So, again 0 and 0, the output is the 1. Next condition, when s equal to 1, r equal to 1. So, we don't know. So, either in this case also we are getting the 0, either in this case also we are getting the output is 0. Okay. So for example, so any one of the input is 1, the output is the 0. Any one of the input is 1, the output is 0. So, is this possible? Not possible. Why? Because, so here one of the input is the original input. So, that Q bar is the combination complementary of that input. So, that means Q equal to 0, Q bar equal to 1. Okay. So, in this case, this is not possible for constructing this one. Is this possible? So, if you are taking, so this output is connected to here. Here, what are getting? 0. So, again, we are taking this input is 0. So, what we are getting? 0 only. Okay, this is the indeterminate state. When s equal to 0, r equal to 0, the outputs are not changing. When s equal to 1, r equal to 1, the outputs are, the output is not determined. So, when s equal to 1, r equal to 0, when s equal to 0, r equal to 1 only, we are getting the values. So, this is the characteristic table for the SR latch. So, each and every flip-flop, we are having the some SR latch or D latch or JK flip-flop, whatever it is. So, here we are taking the one truth table, characteristic table and the excitation table for the each and every flip-flop. So, this is the output truth table for the SR latch. So, when 0, 0, no change of the state. When 0, 1, 0 reset value, 1, 0, 0 reset value. So 1, 1, so it is the indeterminate state. When 0, 0, no change. When 1, 1, indeterminate state. Okay. Now let us assume. So this is the characteristic table for the SR latch using the NOR loop, NOR gate. So S and R Q of T is the input. S and R Q of T is the input. Q of T plus Q bar T of 2 plus 1 is the output conditions. Okay. So Based on this one, here we are writing this equation. When 0, 0, 0, when 0, 0, 0, when 0, 0, the first condition is the when 0, 0, 0. So, first one 0, 0, so what is the output? No change. So, whatever the values are presenting in the previous one, that values are stored here. So, when s equal to 0, r equal to 0, the q of t also 0. So, what is the next q of t plus 1? So, whatever the value are stored in this one, we are writing the value is here. So, that is the q of t plus 1. So, if one of the input is the output is the 0, automatically it is having the inverter of this one. So, 0 will become to the 1. So, next one 0, 0, 1. Next one 0, 0, 1. So, what happened? When 0, 0 is the no change of the state. So, that means whatever the values are stored in the Q of T, then we are getting the Q of T plus 1. Okay. So, when S equal to 0, R equal to 0. So, Q of T equal to 1. Q of T equal to 1. So, whatever the values present in this Q of T. So, that means in the Q of T, we are having the 1 value is there. So, writing this 1. So, if this output is the 1, so, if this output is the 1, what is the complement of this input? 0. Next one, s equal to 0, r equal to 1, s q of t equal to 0. So, s equal to 0, r equal to 1. Okay, when 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0. So, when both the inputs are 1, 1, when both the inputs are 0, 1, both the inputs are 0, 1. So, what we are getting? 0 is the reset value. So, 0, 1, 0. So, here we are observing the only S and R inputs. So, if you are taking the Q of T plus 1, what happened? So, 0 and 1. 0 and 1. So, that means the output value is the 0. The output value is the 0. Next one. 0, 1, 0. Next one is condition is the 010. So what happened in the 010? In the first condition, if you are taking the 01, in the first condition we are taking the 01, that is the output 0. So here the output is the 0. So if this value is the 0, automatically the value is the 1. Next condition 011. So 011. So s equal to 0, r equal to 1, s equal to 0, r equal to 1, q of t equal to also 1. So here we are mainly concentrating on the s and r only. So in the 01, the output is the 0, automatically the inverse of this one is the 1. Next one is 100. Next one is the 100. So that means s equal to 1, r equal to 0. S equal to 1, r equal to 0. S equal to 1, r equal to 0. Okay. So when the s equal to 1, r equal to 0, what happened? The output is the 1. This condition. So that is the output is the 1. Complement of this one, output is the 0. Next one is 10. Again, we are taking the s equal to 1, r equal to 0. So here we are not depending on the q of t. So it's already depending on the present state only. It's only depending on this one, 101. So if we are taking the 10, the output is the 1. Complement of this output is the 0. Next one is 110. Next one is the 110. So that means if you are taking the any one of the input, 11 is the indeterminate state. Indeterminate state. So we don't have the any output values 0000. So this is the characteristic table for the SR latch. So when s equal to 0, r equal to 0, q of t. 0 and 1 is the 0. Reset. That value is the reset. 10 is the set. 10 is the set, the value is the 1. 11 is the across mark indeterminate state. So this is the SR latch without using the clock pulse. Next, using the NAND latch, NAND one. So this is also constructing in the bidirectional nature. So S and R are the inputs, Q and Q bar are the outputs. So what is the NAND gate based SR latch? So S and R are the inputs, Q and Q bar are the outputs. Okay, so before going to this one, so we are writing the truth table for the AB bar. So 00, 01, 10 and 11. So 00 is there. A and B is the 00 bar is 1. 0 and 1 is. So 0 and 1 is the 00 bar is 1. 1 and 0 is the 00 bar is 1. Okay, so next one is the 11. 11. So the output is the 1 bar is 0. So 0 into 0, 0 bar is 1, 0 into 1, 0 bar is 1, 1 into 0, 0 bar is 1, 1 into the output is the 1. So 1 into 1 is the output is the 1, complement of that one is the 0. So this is the NAND gate truth table. So what we are observing, whenever both the inputs are 1, 1, the output is the 0. Whenever both the inputs are 1, 1, the output is the 0. So again we are taking the different types of the flip flops. So first one is the when s equal to 0, r equal to 0. When s equal to 0, r equal to 0. So what happened in the first case? So before that, what we are observing? So when we are taking the NAND gate, when both the inputs are 1, 1, the output is 0. Any one of the input is the either the 0. So either 0, the output is the 1. Okay. So when s equal to 0, r equal to 0. In the first condition, any one of the input is 0, the output is automatically 1. So here what happened? Here one of the input is 0, output is 1. Here one of the input is, output is 1. So is it possible? Not possible. So that's what, here we are assuming the output states. 1 is there, 0 is there. So 0, 0, 1. So next one is, 0 is connected to here. So what we are getting, any one of the input is 0, automatically the output is the 1. So here also same one, 1, 0. 1 and 0. So if you are taking this value is the 0 and this value is the 1. Okay. So first condition, so when both the inputs are S and R only. So only here we are deciding the output states. So this 0 is connected to here. This 1 is connected to here. So what happened? So the output is 0. So next one is 0, 0, the output is the 1. So whatever the previous values is there, same values are presented here. So when the 0, 0 is the indeterminate state. So why? Because one of the input is 0, the output is 1. So here also one of the input is 1, 0, output is 1. So this is the indeterminate state. This is the indeterminate state. So the second class, the second case is the when s equal to 0, r equal to 1. When s equal to 0, r equal to 1. So what happened? Any one of the input is 0, the output is the 1. So 1, 1, 0. Okay, next case, when s equal to 1, r equal to 0. So, s equal to 1, r equal to 0. So, observing the NR latch and the NAND latch. So, in the NR latch, R is connected in the first AND gate, s is connected to here. So, but in this one, we are constructing this one is the also bidirection in nature of this one. So next condition is when s equal to 1, r equal to 0. So any one of the input is 0, the output is the 1. So 1, 1. So the automatically the output is the 0. 1 and 0. Next one, when s equal to 1, r equal to 1. When s equal to 1, r equal to 1. Okay. So any of one of the input is 1. So here we are not deciding this one. So that's why k equal to 0, q bar equal to 1. So this 0 is concreted here. 1, 0, the output is 1. 1, 1, 0. Next case, 1, 0. So here we are observing one of the output is the, one of the output is 1 is connected to here. 1, 1. Next one is, when s equal to 1, r equal to 1, what happened? When s equal to 1, r equal to 1, s equal to 1, r equal to 1. So, we are not deciding so the output. So, that's what here we are assuming q equal to 0, q bar equal to 1. So, if you are assuming q equal to 0, q bar equal to 1, this 0 is connected to here. This 0 is connected to here. So, automatically the output is the 1 into 0, 0, 0 bar is the 1. So, this 1 is connected to here. 1 into 1 is 1, 1 bar is 0. So, we don't know. So, we did not fix this value. The previous values are the 0 and 1. So, either the values are the, either the q equal to 1, q bar equal to 0 also. So, that case, this 1 is connected to here. This 0 is connected to here. So, now 1, 0 is there. 1 into 0 is 0, 0 bar is 1. So similarly, the output 1 equal to 1 equal to, so when both the inputs are zero, 1 0 is the 1 1. So this one 1 1 is there, the output is the 0. So this is the truth table for the NAND gate. When 0 0, this is the indeterminate state. 0 1 is the 1. 1, 0 is the 0, 1, 1 is the q of t, no change. When s equal to 0, r equal to 1, this is the set. 1 equal to 0, s equal to 1, r equal to 0, this is the reset values. So, using the NOR logic, when s equal to 0, r equal to 1, that is the reset. When s equal to 1, r equal to 0, that is the reset values. Okay, so based on this one, we are finding the characteristic table for the SR latch. So, how can we decide? So, first, what are the inputs? S, R, Q of T. Output is the Q of T plus 1 is the Q bar T plus 1. So, here we are taking the three inputs. How many combinations are there? 8 combinations are there. So, first case, when 0, 0. When 0, 0. So, what happened? This is the indeterminate state. So, 0, 0, 0. So, we are not writing the any indeterminate state in this SR latch. So, that's why here we are writing the Q of T plus 1, Q bar T plus 1 is the present outputs. So, 0, 0, 0. So, this is the indeterminate state. So, we cannot write the indeterminate state directly in this truth table. That's why here we are writing the 1, 1. Next one is 0, 0, 1. Next one is 0, 0, 1. So, here also, when 0, 0 is the indeterminate state, so we are not deciding this one, so the outputs are the 1, 1 only. Next one is 0, 1, 0. 0, 1, 0. So, when s equal to 0, r equal to 1, so what happened? The output is the 1. So, here this output is the 1 automatically, this output is the 0. Next case, 0, 1, 1. So, 0, 1 is there, The output is the one. Number is 0. Next case, 100. So when s equal to 1, r equal to 0, what happened? 0. So if here it is not depending on this q of t values. When s equal to 1, r equal to 0, r equal to 0, the output is the 0. 0 bar is the 1. Next, same case, 101. So the set value also 101. So when the s equal to 1, r equal to 0, what happened? 0 is the reset. Q of t plus 1 is the 0. So if this value is the 0, automatically this value is the 1. Next one is 110. So when the inputs are the 1, 1, it is depending on the no change, that is the q of t value. So when this is the 1, 1, the output state is the q of t. So q of t plus 1 is the present input q of t. When 1, 1, the output is the q of t, no change. So here the q of t value is the 0. Same value is reflected here, q of t plus 1. Q of t plus 1. So this one of the output is 0, automatically the another output is the 1. Next one is 111. So when both the inputs are the 1, 1, so what happened? This is the q of t, same one, no change. So here the q of t is the 1. So same one is replaced here. Q of t plus 1 is also the 1. So q bar of t plus 1 is the opposite of this one. This is the 0. This is the characteristic truth table for the NAND SR latch. Thank you.
Like, share, and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.